Uranium is a natural and commonly occurring radioactive element that contributes to natural background and radiation levels. Natural uranium is a mixture of three types of isotopes of uranium: uranium-234, uranium-235, and uranium-238. Uranium occurs naturally in the Earth's crust.
It is present in plants, rocks, soil, water, and animals.
The majority of the uranium deposits in the United States are found in Arizona, Colorado, Nebraska, New Mexico, Texas, Utah, and Wyoming. Radioactive elements are those that undergo spontaneous transformation. During decay, energy is released or emitted, either in the form of alpha or beta particles, or as electromagnetic radiation with energy sufficient to cause ionization, such as gamma rays or X-rays. Uranium is primarily an alpha emitter. Uranium-234 has the shortest half-life and is therefore the most radioactive, followed by uranium-235 and uranium-238. Natural uranium is radioactive but poses more of a chemical hazard because of its very long half-life. When uranium gives off radiation, it transforms into another substance, such as radon. Unlike other kinds of radiation, the alpha radiation ordinarily given off by uranium cannot pass through solid objects, such as paper or human skin. Enriched uranium contains more of the fissionable uranium-235, which is the energy source used for reactors and weapons. Low-enriched uranium is used in civilian reactors. High-enriched uranium is used in naval reactors and for weapons production. The enrichment of uranium for nuclear weapons began back in the 1940s. Its use in energy production began in the 1950s. Depleted uranium is created as a byproduct of the uranium enrichment process and possesses about 60% of the radioactivity found in natural uranium. Due to its high density, it can be used as a radiation shielding material. Depleted uranium is used on helicopters and airplanes. It is used as shielding to protect army tanks. It's used on bullets and missiles to enable them to penetrate armored vehicles. Depleted uranium is present in shrapnel and will contaminate wounds when embedded in soft tissue. The high energy alpha particles from the uranium in the shrapnel may be a source of systemic exposure over time. Uranium is redistributed on the Earth by various natural and industrial processes. Natural processes such as weathering, volcanic eruption, and wind and water erosion. Industrial processes include uranium mine tailing disposal, extraction of phosphorus from phosphate ores to produce phosphate fertilizers, and uranium mining and milling to produce uranium oxides. Uranium tailings are a waste byproduct of uranium. In mining, raw uranium ore is brought to the surface and crushed into a fine sand. The valuable uranium-bearing materials are then removed via heap leaching with the use of acids or bases. The remaining radioactive sludge, called uranium tailings, is stored in large impoundments. Uranium is currently used to fuel nuclear power plants, create medical isotopes, and is used for industrial and military defense purposes. Occupational activities that potentiate worker exposure to uranium include processing nuclear fuel, producing phosphate fertilizers, operating power plants, creating, repairing, storing, transporting, and using uranium weapons, working with aircraft components containing uranium, working with uranium-containing glass and glazes. But the workers who are most heavily exposed to uranium are employed in mining and milling operations, or in uranium enrichment and processing activities. The most common non-occupational exposure is from naturally occurring uranium sources, such as contaminated well water, which is more likely when a water source is located near mining sites. Routes of exposure include ingestion, inhalation, and dermal absorption. Inhalation of uranium powder is the primary route of exposure for workers. Ingestion is the most common route for those in the general public. The average uranium concentration in water is 2.5 micrograms per liter. Daily estimated oral intake for both food and water is approximately 3.0 micrograms per day. Higher exposures are expected in communities where uranium mining or milling takes place. Workers exposed to alpha particle emitting uranium compounds must protect themselves by wearing personal protective clothing, respirators, and eye protection. The OSHA permissive exposure limit for airborne soluble uranium in the workplace is 0.05 milligrams per cubic meter over an 8-hour time-weighted average. Soluble uranium compounds are more readily absorbed into the body compared to insoluble uranium. For airborne insoluble uranium, the permissive exposure limit at the workplace is 0.25 milligrams per cubic meter over an 8-hour time-weighted average. Workers must be limited to no more than 8 hours of exposure per day and no more than 40 hours per week of the aforementioned permissive exposure limits for both soluble and insoluble uranium. The Nuclear Regulation Commission and the Department of Energy limit external radiation to 5 rentogram equivalents in man per year, or 0.05 sieverts. The EPA maximum contaminant level is 30 micrograms per liter in the public drinking water system. No human cancer of any type has ever been reported as a result of exposure to natural or depleted uranium. However, enriched uranium has the potential to increase the chance of developing cancer. After an inhalation exposure, most of the deposited uranium clears rapidly via mucociliary transport and is either released with sputum or is swallowed, where 95% is excreted into the feces. A portion of the uranium can reside in the lungs for years. Nearly 70% of the uranium absorbed in the blood is filtered through the kidneys and is cleared within 24 hours through the urine. The majority of retained uranium exists in the kidneys and skeleton. Bone is the primary long-term deposit site for ingested and insoluble forms of uranium. The pulmonary lymph nodes are the chief long-term deposit site for inhaled uranium. The majority of uranium is cleared quickly from the body. Therefore, high uranium concentrations in the urine, greater than 100 micrograms per liter, reflect current or recent exposures, while low concentrations of less than 40 micrograms per liter are more likely a result of past exposure or typical background exposures. It is important to emphasize that elevated urinary uranium concentrations indicate exposure, but they do not necessarily indicate adverse effects. In addition, biomarkers of nephrotoxicity are not unique to uranium exposure. Oral doses or infusions of sodium bicarbonate may be administered to maintain an alkaline urine. Alkaline urine prevents dissociation of the uranium bicarbonate complex that protects the renal tubular epithelium from exposure to the reactive uranyl ion. The use of chelation drugs for acute uranium overexposure is considered controversial practice in the United States. Precipitation of uranium in the kidney may cause additional damage. Patient instructions should include avoidance of overexposure by making behavioral changes in the work and non-work settings. If the exposure was from contaminated well water, bottled water, or alternative water sources are needed for recovery and prevention.
Examples of districts that are at risk include District 5, District 6, District 9, District 11, District 12, District 13. Worker safety advised.